Very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Very good evening to the young adults who are ready to spread their wings and take their flight off to the real world of employment. And very good evening to all the participants of Employ Special. Employ Special is an initiative of Sunrise Learning Foundation that is meant to provide platforms of opportunities and soft skill trainings to differently and specially abled people who would want to explore more boundaries of employment. And today we have with us a very special team, diversity and inclusion team of SAP. And Meena ji is here. Meena ji is the vice president at SAP. And to let everybody know, SAP was one of the first companies in India that were employing people who had some special needs, especially in the space of autism. SAP globally hires many people on the autism spectrum. And Meena's team is also working with three or four people on the autism spectrum. And this session is with Ms. Meena and our colleagues from SAP who have been really active in hiring people on the autism spectrum as well as working with them. So today they will talk about their experiences, the kind of jobs that these candidates are doing and what they are best at. And what is SAP looking at while hiring people on the autism spectrum? And I think as a surprise, we would also get to meet some of our friends who are on the spectrum, who are working with SAP in the coming session. So over to you for now, Meena and Karthike. Thank you so much for taking out your time and being with us today for this insightful and very, very exciting session.
Thanks, Sonali, for the introduction. As Sonali mentioned, we are a team from SAP who have been working with people on the autism spectrum, especially. And we discussed with Sonali on how do we engage and what is the value that we can bring forward to her initiative and to people who are on the autism spectrum or specially special needs people around the India. So we decided that what we will share is our experiences that we have in SAP of engaging with people on the autism spectrum and also introduce the career choice of software testing, because we have seen that many people that we have hired are doing either software testing or quality assurance, which are a little bit connected topics, and we wanted to give a little bit of a little bit introduction to that topic so that you can understand what it is and explore it further. Sonali could explore it, or you individually could explore that topic. So we have divided the topic into two different sessions, today and next week. Today, I'm going to talk about SAP's journey into the autism spectrum and hiring people with special needs. We are going to talk about experiences from my colleague Amit. He's a manager of one of the candidates for autism, how his experiences have been. And Karthik, who has been the buddy for most of the candidates on the autism spectrum. If they don't open to anybody, they open to Karthik, right? So he has been really, really a very, very capable guy who has that connect with the people from the spectrum. The next week, the session that we are going to have, in a colleague Manas from who has been working in Karthik's team, who will introduce what does he do every day, what is his work like, what does he do on an everyday basis, and what did he learn and his experiences, so that people can connect to him. And before I start into the session, I also wanted to give a brief introduction about three of us. To start with me, Sonali already mentioned that I am a vice president at SAP. I am also a diversity and inclusion lead for my group globally, which is around 2,500 strong group. I have been associated with topics on diversity and inclusion both for last 5 to 6 years. And have been working with candidates on the autism spectrum for last 3 to 4 years. So I have within my own team around 3 people on the autism spectrum who are working, and in Karthik's team we have another 2 who are working on the autism spectrum. So that's briefly my introduction, and I will pass it on to Amit to briefly introduce yourself.
Hello everybody, my name is Amit Agrawal. I have been with SAP for around 15 years now, and I am a development manager. And why I'm here today is because I have one person who is from autism spectrum, and apart from that, I am also associated with diversity and inclusion program. I'm a D&I lead from Gurgaon, and also I have been involved in hiring of people with autism spectrum. So I'm privileged to be here today. Thank you.
Thanks, over
to
Karthik. Amit. Karthik.
Hello everyone. Myself Karthik, and I work as product expert in SAP. More than that, I'm a mentor at Autism at Work program and a friend for everyone in the autism spectrum in our company. I teach yoga, we do running together. Recently, we went for a road trip also last weekend, you know. So basically, we have fun together. That's about me. Thank you.
Thanks, Karthik. So let's continue on the slide deck. If, let's say, you find difficulty anywhere, please let us know. We'll be using mostly English as the medium of language, but if you want us to switch at any point of time, please let us know. Okay, can we go on to the next slide, Karthik? So SAP, I think you might be knowing that diversity and inclusion both are a very important topic for all organizations today, and that includes SAP as well. When we say diversity, we mean to say that include, and inclusion, we mean to say including everybody. No bias, even in terms of gender, that this is a male and this is a female, or in terms of abilities, that somebody is in the autism spectrum or somebody has some physical disabilities because of which we kind of differentiate them. The idea is to include everybody, because everybody brings in different things on the table which are important for the organization. And what is very important, all of you need to understand, is that when any company creates products, if SAP is creating products, for company is creating phones or any other product, these products are used by everybody. They are also used by special needs people. So that is why it's very important that when we are creating such products, we have people from all different aspects, all diversity aspects into the organization, because that is when we will make the best products which are usable for all. So that is what we need to understand. It is not a charity or anything like that. It is something that we really value because we think that it brings value to the organization. Okay, next slide, please. So we sometimes talk about equality, but there is a difference between equality and equity. So if you see this picture, we can say that, okay, there are 3 people and we are equality. We have given them the same size of the bench to go and see something, right? But we are not considering that what each one is bringing on or what is the strengths and weaknesses of each one of those, and we are not helping, enabling them to give their best, right? Whereas in the second picture, where we talk about equity, we are providing a platform such that each of them is able to contribute equally, right? So that's the difference between when we talk about really inclusion in an organization. Okay, next slide. So we launched SAP Autism Program in 2013 globally, and right now we have more than 175 colleagues on the spectrum across SAP in 27 different roles, and we are covering 14 countries and 31 locations globally. Okay, next slide, please. So when we hire a person on the autism spectrum, what you need to understand is that he's not alone in the organization. We have a support system in the workplace, in the office, and we have a support system also coming from the home. So if you look at the office workspace, we have the HR, which are the human resources people. We have the manager, who plays a very, very key role. We have the local team, which works on the autism space. We have Archana and some other people who are involved there. We have the autism mentor, where Karthik comes into picture. He's playing that particular role. And we also have buddies, So we also have multiple people with whom they can talk anything. It needn't be work, who help them on general help activities and stuff like that to get them comfortable in a workspace. And of course, from a personal space, the family, the personal counselors that are involved or other support system also are important. And together, we work to make this employee comfortable and productive in due course of time. Okay, next slide, please. So this shows that from every country, how many people on the autism spectrum are working with our organization. So we'll see that in India, we are 17. Even though we started this program in India, you will see that some other countries like Germany and US are doing better than us. And one of the main reasons, which I think you can relate to, is the support system that we are able to provide right from the beginning when the child is small and is found on autism spectrum. There are many people on the autism spectrum in the country, but they could be in villages, small towns, where they're not getting the right environment and support system to thrive and to reach a state that is employable. So I would really thank Sonali and her team in bringing in various ideas and thinking hard that what are the different ways in which we can employ everybody. Maybe what we are going to talk about today is not going to help everybody who's in the team today, who's here, right? Because it depends on what are their strengths. Do they fit into this environment or some other environment? But the idea is to be aware of what all possibilities are there and to see what is best for each person on the autism spectrum. Keeping strengths in picture. Okay, next slide, please. Okay. Now I hand it over to Amit to talk about why we are looking at autism people for testing, what are the strengths they bring in, what is his personal experiences, and then we will, after that, Karthik will show us some real example. Over to Amit.
Thank you, Meena. So let us look at what are the strengths of people with autism spectrum. So you can see that, you know, the people with autism spectrum, they have amazing attention to the details in task. So they can execute things with a lot of concentration, where a lot of concentration is required, they can do it very nicely. They are some of the people with autism spectrum, they also, you know, have special abilities. For example, some people have unparalleled photographic memories. I know I know a few person who can remember, you know, they have wonderful, excellent memories to remember dates, to remember data. And also, many people from autism spectrum, they also have the ability to think out of the box. So there are various situations in which a person who is not from this spectrum, he might not notice those things, or he might not come up with, you know, a unique idea, which we might get from a person with autism spectrum. So Karthik, can you move to the next slide? So we have people with autism working in different roles in SAP. So we have mainly people in testing roles, then we also have quality assurance, and then there are some people who are also supporting in admin and office support roles. So as part of this presentation, we'll be focusing more about testing and quality assurance, and in further slides we'll be detailing out what do we mean by testing and quality assurance. Karthik, can you move? So now, why quality and software testing we are going to focus upon? Because software quality assurance and testing, we from experience, we know that it's not everybody's cup of tea. It requires special skills. It requires a lot of discipline. It also has repetition, and it requires execute attention to details. And these are the qualities which match with people with autism spectrum. Maybe in the next slide we can see. So what does an ideal software and a QA tester need? What are the things which we look for if we are hiring somebody for a software QA or a tester role? So the person should be having good memory so that he can remember the facts, he can remember a few things. And then he should be persistent, because this requires a lot of follow-up. with different people in the organization and to check various things. So it requires a lot of persistence. And it also needs methodological adherence to instructions for activities. The person has to be, you know, very methodological. He should not be, you know, deviating from the instructions. And as I mentioned earlier, he should also be having an eye to detect these deviations from what is expected. So maybe next slide, Karthik. For example, to differentiate how a normal person who is not on a autism spectrum and how a person who is on the autism, how do they differ? So this is a quote from one of the person who is from ULTRA testing team. His name is Todd, and he describes how he has different abilities than people, you know, who are not on this spectrum. So he says that when other people go out to drive a car, they just go out and they, you know, they just say that you go out for your car. But when he sees a person going out to a car, he sees that a person actually opens the door, he goes downstairs, then he walks towards the car, and then he starts the car. So you can see the kind of attention to each and every detail, every moment. So this kind of strength is very helpful for testing, which actually people with autism spectrum have. So next slide, Karthik. So what do we mean by testing? So testing is something not something new. We most of us are aware of testing. We have various forms of testing which we undergo, you know, in our lives. For example, right now in these days, we all have heard about COVID test. So basically here, we know that there is some kind of virus which gets into human body as a defect. And the purpose of this COVID testing is to find out that defect. And if that defect is found, then that needs to be, you know, resolved by giving some medication. So this is like one of the case of the testing. Then on the right side, you will see that a person is trying to see a diamond. He's looking at it very closely. So he's trying to test if the diamond is of good quality. There might be some blemishes in that or some cracks. So the person is trying to test a diamond for the quality. So yeah, next slide. So now let's talk about what is software testing and what is a defect in software. So here you see a screen. You might be using various websites, various mobile applications. So this is one of the websites. I think this is for immigration for Canada. And you can see that on the left side, it says that, okay, there are various languages which somebody has to choose. For example, English, French, and probably the downward, that is maybe Chinese or maybe Japanese. Yeah, that one is Chinese. So on the right side, the expected, what is expected in this screen is that on the dropdown, you should see three languages spelled out very properly, like English, French, and Chinese. But there is a defect on this page. You can see the English and Chinese, they are appearing correctly, but French is not appearing correctly. There are some different characters which are appearing. And the purpose of a tester is exactly to find out what is wrong with such pages or such applications so that they can report these defects to the person who's developing these pages. And this way they can avoid this page being used by, you know, the end user, because it is not nice for a company that if a person who is using the web page, they find that there are defects because of which the site maybe might be unusable. So this was about software testing and the defects identification. Then on the next slide, I'll talk about what is quality assurance. So as Meena said, that quality assurance and testing, they are very closely interrelated. So like I talked about various kind of defects and also about testing software quality defects. So in order to make sure that we are able to identify those defects and resolve them, there has to be a process in any organization. So if we are not following that process, then these defects will leak out or they will escape to the end user. So in this screen, you can see that these are various stages of a quality assurance process. For example, whenever, let's say, if somebody has to develop a new page or a new application, then some people have to sit and they have to discuss about the requirements, like what should that page look like? What all features should be there? For example, if let's say we are talking about WhatsApp, then we have to, the person who's developing it, he has to decide, okay, the app will be used for sending messages. You can send photographs using that app. And then we also have to, the next stage is test planning. So once this app is being developed by a group of person who are called developers, then we have to test before we can release it, or before the end user can use it, so that there are no defects in it. So that is called test planning. And in test planning, people basically decide who all will be testing it, what all will be tested. And then the next step is test design. So test design is about that, okay, somebody will be writing a piece of document in which he will mention, let's say, if somebody wants to upload an image using WhatsApp, I'm just using WhatsApp as an example, then that person should be able to upload an image. So this is one of the test case. And so after we have written this document, so some there'll be a tester who will be actually going reading this document, and he will try to execute, he will try to perform that instruction, that once the software comes to him for testing, he will actually try to upload an image and see if he's able to upload it correctly or not. And if there is an error, let's say he's not able to upload an image, then he will report it back to the development team that there is a problem with the page, so please fix it. So once the development team fixes that defect, it comes back to the tester again for retesting. So at this stage, if the tester performs that test, that instruction again, and he is able to upload that image, that is the time he can say, okay, everything is okay, so now this can be released. So this is the final stage. So this way we try to reduce the defects from any application. So yeah, next slide, Karthik. So now I hand over to Karthik. He will try to talk more about the defects, the software defects, and how to identify. He'll give a demo about that. So over to you, Karthik.
Thank you, Amit. So since I am presenting full screen, I couldn't get a chance to get a feel of the audience who are all there. So let me try to kind of, yeah, see it once. Yeah, now I'm able to see. Hello, everyone. Myself, Karthik. And so far, we had a wonderful narrative on about autism at work in SAP from Meena, and about experiences of having a tester in the autism spectrum and the qualities of good tester from Amit. Now we are going to see the practical, you know. So let us make it more interactive, okay? So when we think of a software or anything, you know, so there should be requirements in place. I understand there are parents also involved. Some of you already aware of the software quality testing. Especially, I would like to involve the students here who are looking for kind of employment. So a requirement, what is requirement? Let us think of a phone. So a phone has multiple requirements. We need a phone to make calls. We need a phone to send messages. We need a phone to make use of social media apps. We need a phone for multiple other purposes, right? These are all the requirements of a user from a phone. So the source of problem in a software is used for people to enter information into it, to process information. So now they have their own requirements, like how we have requirements on using a phone. These requirements can go completely mismatched, or the requirements were not met in the product after the product is released. Like you get a phone, you buy a phone, and you are not able to make calls. So you are not able to satisfy the needs of yours. So these are all the requirements, incomplete requirements, which can happen with the software also. Some customer uses the application and suddenly it is not working for their needs or requirements. So this can be one source of problem. The second source of problem is a design. So we know that a phone should have a camera. Let's say it should be at the left side of the rear side of the phone. It can be designed in such a way they kept it in the middle of the phone, the design, you know. So this is a design flaw. Similarly, in a software, when you have an application, if you, some of you use Facebook, some of you use Gmails in your daily lives. So it could be that instead of having the username and password next, in some application, there can be a password field first and then username. It's a completely a design flaw, right? We need to have the right fields in the right place. That is the flaw in design. The third thing, the source of problem in a software could be that implementation. So again, example going with the phone, we have something, some social media app, Facebook, or let's say Gmail. So Gmail, somebody has to write a code, right? So they have to write a code to make it work. When you send a mail, it has to go, right? But think of it in a way that you send it, it has to reach immediately. But due to some problem in the implementation, the mail goes to the person after 2 days. Can you live with it? No, right? In current world, we need immediately the response has to go, right? So this is an implementation flaw. So somebody has coded it, and it is not working as expected. So these are all the three different problems which we can find in the software also. So these are the three source of problems. Now I'm going to talk about the deliverables. So a tester has to be there. When a software is developed, the tester has to develop, tester has to test the software and make sure the requirements are met and the problems in the design is not there. And the third thing, there are no issues in the implementation. If there are any issues in all three phases, tester is the person who is going to find it out. So he's a kind of detective who is going to find out the problems in the software. So now in the test deliverables, what are the test deliverables available? Deliverables means when you do the testing, it is a process, as Amit shared. First, they do the development, think of manufacturing the phone, the first phone, and then it has to go to the quality to make sure it is being tested to find out the defects. So this is the deliverables in the testing software. We have something called test plan. Test plan is nothing but what needs to be done, how to test it, all the details at a summary level will be added in it. And who will do it? The author is test lead. In a testing team, you will have a test lead and then test cases. So for each functionality, they will have a separate document step by step how to do it. That is what test case. And finally, when the tester finds some defect, he has to log into the tool saying that I tested this, I find problem in this particular scenario. So that is what the defects tool. And finally, all this process goes. They have to send a weekly report to the management team. Okay, this product, we tested it, and these are all the number of issues our testers found, and this cannot be released to customers. This phone, for example, this phone cannot be sold out to customers until all these problems, 1, 2, 3, can be solved. And finally, the test closure report. Got it? So this is more of the steps involved. You know, and this flowchart explains, you can just have a look at this flowchart for yourself. So it starts and then the tester report defects and test lead checks the defects and validate it. And the dev lead, development lead, assign the defect, because if the problem is there, the developer has to solve the problem, right? So assign the defects and then developer solves the problem. So the developer has to fix the problem. And then again, it comes back to tester. The tester retests it, whether the problem is solved. If it is solved, That's where he closes the defect. If it is not solved, again, it has to go back to the developer. Developer has to work on it and fix the problem. So this is the overall flow of the whole testing process. Now it's interesting. We will get into the practical. So I'm going to open. So you should be able to see a document. Can you see it?
Can you increase the font size, please, or the view to 120 or a little bit more? Yeah.
Is it better?
Yeah.
So what we are going to test today, so this is the test case document, what I have, you know. I will also open the test application. What application we are going to test? We are going to test an employee management application. So I'll just copy the link. I'll open the application also. And I will open something, a tool. When you find the defect, you'll be uploading in the tool. So I have opened three different applications in the browser. The first one is the test case, which gives what needs to be tested. And the second is the actual application I'm going to test. And the third thing is the tool where you'll be entering the defects. Okay, so now let's get into the test case. So you will, as a tester, you will get a test case like this from the test lead. And then you have to read it. Let's go through it. So Orange HRM system is a web-based employee management system. Administrators will add employees, and employees can add their name, address, photos in the system. So this is a simple application, you know, employee management system. In a company, a lot of employees joined, right? So they have to add all the details of employees, their name, personal details, and they have to give user login and password, like how you log into Facebook, Gmail, so that you can manage your whole personal information, adding your address and other things, right? So this application is helping the company to do that. Now they say that testers can access the site using Chrome browser to test it. And what you see here is the test case ID. Test case ID, it has a ID identification. So this test case ID is TC_1. So this is just a numbering for reference. Now what we are going to test is test objective. What is the test objective? Let's say Sonali ma'am is your school president. She acts as an administrator. You have teachers, a lot of teachers in the school. So she wanted to add an employee, you know, some employee. So administrator adding the employee is the test case we are going to test. And they say precondition. Precondition is what needs to be there. So you need to have an admin account. Sonali ma'am has to have an admin account in order to add teacher. And this application is, she's opening this application, you know. So already I have opened the application. Now there is already admin user. So here in the test case, what does it say? Click the link to open the site. So this is the link, I opened it. Now what does it say? In the login panel, login as an admin, admin 123. So I'm going to log in, admin, admin 123. Now what it will do, the administrator is able to log in to the application. Got it? So now we'll go back to the test case again. So admin logged in, click the login, logged in. Now what does it do? It says click menu PIM, personal information management, and click the menu add employee. let's go find it out. So here is PIM. I go to PIM and it says add employee. I'm going to click add employee. It's all step by step, nothing complex. So we have to just follow the steps. This document will be provided to the testers. Now, what does it say? Enter the first name as Karthik and then click save button without entering the last name. Everyone will have a first name and last name, right? So this test case is saying that I have to enter Karthik and not enter anything here. Now I click next. Instead of save, it should be next. So it says, what happened here? I get last name required error. So here they have mentioned, right? What is the expected result? System should raise error required field for last name field. So we get it, the error, right? Required. So now it's our time, tester job, to update the actual result. Yes, test case passed. System raised error. What we have done is we have basically tested one particular test case. And what you do, there is a tool. What you'll be doing, let's say Sonali ma'am is testing, you know. So I have to put the test case ID. We saw, right, test case ID. What is the test case ID here? TC_1. And what is the test step number? Test step number is 6. So I give it here 6. Test step status. We got the error, right? As expected, we got the error, right? Which means it is passed. So if actual result is same as expected result, select passed. Okay. And what is the actual result that came? Just copy paste it. Whatever you have documented here, what was the error came? Submit. Thank you for documenting the results of test case. Appreciate your effort. Good job. So we started with the first test case. We have completed testing one test case, one test step, right? Now let's get into the step 7. Now what does this step 7 says? Enter the last name as Kapoor123#. Go here, Kapoor123#. And a last name have numbers and special character for anyone? Can anyone say it? No, right? I see a lot of heads nodding no. So let us say I'm going to give it. And then let's see. So I'm click next. So here, for example, I click next. See, it should have thrown me error, right? Let us see. Here, what does it say? System should raise error, special characters not allowed. Does it throw an error for us? No. So what does it mean? We have to enter the actual result. System does not raise error. Test case passed or failed? Failed, yes. Very good. So we have to just copy paste again, meet another response, go there. Again, same thing, same test case ID it is, but test number is different. 7 we tested, we put it 7, failed, and copy paste the result. Submit. So we have tested 2 test steps so far. Now let's get into the third one. So now again, it says repeat step 5. Let me go to the step 5. What is the step 5 here? Click menu and add employee. I go here, add employee again. And what does it say here? I have to add Karthik this time and Kapoor, which is right, you know, and then select the location. And then what does it say next? Select create login detail. If somebody has to, employee has to log in, he has to have a username and password, right? Without that, he cannot log in. So create login detail. Enter the username as Karthik123. Username Karthik123. And password value as 123. Okay, 123. What is the expected result? System should rise error, should have at least 8 characters. Password, can you have 2 characters for password? No, right? So let us see whether system thrown. Yes, I see. Right? Your password should have at least 8 characters. Try a different password. So now I write the actual results. System raised error. This case passed or failed? Passed, right? It thrown error. This case passed. Then you copy it. Then go here. Again the same thing. You get the test case number. And what is the test step number here? You type it. 11. Test case failed. Actual result. Copy it. Got it. Now what they say? 12. Type the password Karthik@123. Karthik@123. Select status enabled and click the save button. Status enabled. We also had to confirm password, right? 2 times we have to give. Karthik123@123. Now I click next. Great. So the employee is created and the user login is created. So expected result, employee personal details should be displayed. And we can see that it is displayed as, right? Whatever we added, Karthik, Kapoor, the name. Now the employee can add further details when he logs in. So this test case is done. We log out. So we just add it here. Actual details, employee personal details got displayed. Okay, you got it, right? So this is the whole process. Now let's deal with the second test case. Now Sonali ma'am has added her teacher in the school.
Karthik, just 1 minute. So Sonali, we are going to show another test case to kind of give a feeling of how the entire testing is, but in interest of time, we have 15 minutes to go. So are we comfortable showing that, or do you want to open for Q&A, question answers?
Well, the purpose of showing these kinds of demonstrations is to help the participants, the parents, and the young adults to understand, to get a sneak peek into what is quality assurance and what is testing, into the world of testing, which I believe has been conveyed very beautifully, thanks to Karthik and thanks to Meena and the team. So what I understand from this testing is that there is one kind of task that has to be repeated and repeated and repeated and repeated, which perhaps can be done best by people who are on the spectrum, and the regular people might be finding it very difficult to and tedious perhaps to do it, to do the same kind of task again and again, and which requires a lot of, undoubtedly it requires exquisite detailing. So that point is beautifully conveyed. If the next demo has to convey something beyond this, we are more than happy to have it. If you want to take it to the next session, even then we are more than happy to do that. So
nothing, so nothing much. I'm just going to say that once the employee is created, you know, now employee logins, right? Employee has to log in. So that's the only information we wanted to convey here. So you have a username Karthik123. Now the employee logins.
Yeah. So Karthik, basically what I'm, because you showed 3 to 4 examples for people to understand what testing is, they have understood it. Now it's another example that you're going to show. But I think I'm more curious to see that what questions do people have? And since we are only 10 minutes, we can maybe address that. And when next session, next week, when we have Manas showing his work, if we get a feedback that they want to see some more examples, we can add that there. Fair?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah. Okay.
I also have the exercise in one of the slide. Whatever I have followed, right, you can follow yourself. That's the good thing. You know, now I have done all the step by step, right? So Sonali ma'am will share the presentation with you. You can follow each and every step what I did. I'll be watching it, the form, whether you do it or not, when you submit it. Thank you.
Thanks, Karthik.
That's wonderful. Yes, so nice. So basically, the point is that it is for the participants to understand what awaits them, what kind of work awaits them when they actually enter the arena of a full-time employment as a quality tester. Is that right? Am I putting it right?
Yes.
Oh, fantastic. So let's hear it from the participants if they have any questions. Vandana ma'am is really amused at what quality testing and testing is all about. She is the head of the computer skills that are being taught to our students, and they have come a really long way in from keyboarding to actually doing meaningful work. So any questions, anyone, please? Priya Mama, you've unmuted yourself. Do you want to ask any question? Vandana ma'am, you want to ask something?
Yeah.
Siddharth Mama is also here.
Yes, thanks Karthik for giving such a nice demo. I belong to IT company, and I have, I know that I was in development for around 12 to 13 years. So I was thinking, now as I am the mentor for the children, so I was thinking that I should introduce testing to them, but I was not getting the idea that how to go with this. So should I do manual, or should I go, should I teach them automated, or how should I go about it? And the simple example which you demonstrated today has given me a lot of ideas, and now surely in next 1 year, Sonali ma'am, and we are going to implement with the adults, with the bigger, with the adult children. And I got an idea how to start with, and also I got an idea what are the prerequisites. Like we need to work a lot. We need to work a lot to reach at that level. One question I have is like the people who are employed in SAP, are they doing only manual testing, or are they also into the automated? So they have been given the test cases and they execute the same, or they do write the case test cases by themselves also.
Karthik, do you want to answer, or shall I pick this up?
Amit, you want to take first, or can I take? Yeah, please.
Yeah, you can take, Karthik.
Okay, so it depends again. It depends again on the strengths of the person, you know, what we have in place. So mostly we go with the manual testing, you know, because you have the list of steps documented in a document, and there will be a buddy also, you know, if you have any questions there. Because when you, we try to make sure that all the details to the T level, it is document, it has to be documented. Because how clear we document the testing will be as effective as possible. You know, it's like we can think of so many defects, right, that can arise from the software. So all cases has to be documented. And here comes a tester. He's happy to test morning to evening, 9 to 5, without any breaks also fine, even weekends also fine, you know. So I got to hear from one of the managers that they have to answer to the candidate why it was a holiday during weekend. They thought that they have to work in weekend also. So just to give a perspective about it, right? I'm not just saying for the sake of advocacy of autism, but surely I saw that some of the brilliant talents were there. But automated, to answer your question, very few cases we do provide automation also. We do have some.
Yeah, and just to add on, Vandana, so this is always a question that even goes in my mind that since now there's a lot of stress on automated testing, so if we kind of put our mind on manual testing, will it stay? So my perspective is some amount of manual testing will always stay first, right? Even 100% automation sometimes is not possible. And you will do some manual testing and then maybe shift to automated. Right. So I think it is very important because manual testing also gives people a little bit of a variation on how to go step by step instruction. And you can start with manual testing, giving that experience to your people. And then slowly you can also interact with our people. Our people can be some, we can assign some coaches, buddies from our team to you who can help you to devise a plan. That how do you train your people? What is already available, which you can easily consume over internet? And if you have to teach any bit of an automation, not creating automated scripts, but maybe even when automated scripts are created, they are in tools. So we still need quality assurance. So we need people who are ensuring that these particular automated testing is done every day or whatever is the frequency, what are the results coming, are people fixing it? So there is still some kind of a quality assurance job that is required to be done. And that could be your next step. But we are long way to completely give away manual testing. And if people get experience in manual testing, it will kind of open up their profile, not only to manual testing, but also to operational jobs. Right, whatever operational jobs are to be done, if they're able to follow instructions which are a little varied, then it opens up a little bit more career choices.
Yeah.
Okay, I also have a question. It might not be as technical as this session is. It's a very, it could be silly also. But my question is, can you share some ideas as to what kind of testing protocols should we create for our young champs to work on? We are not creating any software that needs to be tested. And what is it that we can give them to practice their testing skills and to develop our own protocols? Vandana ma'am has already thought of something, I guess.
Yeah, I have got the idea that how can we introduce them. There are a lot of automate, like there are a lot of forms. Whenever we go to any site, there are many forms which needs information to be added, something like that. So we can start with that. We don't need to explain pass fail at that time. First thing we need to teach them is to fill in the right information. So we can create Google Doc forms, Google Docs, where if they will enter a there is in Google Doc form, we can do little bit of programming. So we can have some
I understand. Yes.
Protocols added to that. So
sure,
I that.
Sure.
Am I right?
Right. Just to,
am I right, Meena and Karthik?
You are right. Yeah. And also there are, for example, I think what Karthik picked up is available freely on the internet. So you can also kind of search and you will get certain applications of testing which are freely available that you can practice with. But with Google Forms, you're right, you can do a lot without much programming. So with your, basically you can experiment with that. And those are the basics steps you can take, and in the long run, then you can find out if there is a testing institute you need to tie up with, which is adding value. Many a times these testing institutes are also not that great, but so we don't need to waste our money, but really see whether we are getting value out of it. But we are definitely willing to coach, put you across some people from our team who have that experience, who can guide you create that curriculum.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
So there are free software. Just to add to Meena, there are free software. You don't need to worry about it, you know. So the slide I shared, you can go with that format.
Yeah, there is a lot of open source available. We can make use of that. But yes, I will need help from others. Alone, doing it alone is a big task for me. So I would need your help in that.
Yeah, sure.
Mm-hmm. Amazing. Great. So I think this session was extremely powerful, and it was way more exciting and insightful than we had even thought of. So fantastic. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Meena, Karthikeyan, and Amit. Thank you once again, Team SAP. Thank you to the participants. Thank you, Vanna ma'am, for taking us to the next step. And special thanks I want to give to Aditya Ganju for giving us this connect with Meena and with SAP, if he's listening. And thank you to all the wonderful participants who gave their precious time today. So this is it for today. We are meeting next Wednesday, 4 o'clock. Again, same platform, same link. And we'll go to the next level of employment readiness.
Yeah. And I would encourage that you have your kids attend that session, because we will have one among you talk about his experiences.
Awesome. Yes. Thank you.
There is one query I think that got unanswered that I can see in the message box. What are the basic qualifications that SAP looks for the employment of individuals with autism?
Yeah. So we have been flexible over time. Initially, we were quite flexible, I would say, to tell you very frankly. So we have even people who have given 12th through their open schooling. We have also people like that, but we also have people who are higher function people who have done their engineering, or they have done some graduation or something like that. But we also have people, at least one candidate who has given 12th exam from open schooling. So we have been talking about it within our organization, whether we can be more open in taking people rather than looking at qualifications. I would say that we are open if we see that somebody can do the tasks that we need to do, organizations like SAP and others can look into it. So concentrate on skill building. I think that's very, very important. And yes, through open skilling, if it's not too much of a pressure, if you're able to handle, fine, do it. I know it is quite a bit of pressure for some parents. Take your take your decision. And as I said, what we showed you is not necessarily for everybody, right? This is one set of employment that Sonali is showing to all of you. But there are many others. There's hospitality. There is so many other sectors. There are call centers. I know that there is one place called Amba in Bangalore. They are doing some excellent work, right? So we can engage with them and check what are they doing, right? What is the kind of work that they are doing in this space, and what is the people that they have? What have they studied? But I would say skills are more important than degree, is my personal viewpoint.
Yeah. Maybe just to add to it, we talked about, so autism, I understand it's a spectrum, right? So what I have from my experiences found is if somebody in Asperger's, so surely it's a call, get a computer, get some digital devices to them and try to see whether what they do with it, It just comes over because they are very good in computer skills. So that would be the better way to build on the skills, as Meena said. And qualification, if they can do a kind of on a correspondence, just for a sake, right? In our country, we still, the companies first look for qualification. So it's always better to have some open schooling qualification, and then skill building is the key here. Yeah. Hope we answered the question.
Thank you very much. And it was a superb session. Thank you once again. Looking forward to the next session on next Wednesday. Thanks a lot to the SAP team and the Sunrise Learning team for the wonderful session. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.